guys. Welcome to my my Vault Hunters gameplay tutorial and let's play commentary. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna launch into the game. And I'm gonna play with some of my friends. Hey guys, I just joined the Minecraft server, and it seems like we're not getting kicked out anymore. I changed a couple of settings in the settings menu and things seem to be working pretty well. I'm gonna go find my friends and I'm gonna check back in with you guys later. Okay guys, so we have a situation here. We have some enemies on us and I'm having trouble finding my friends. I'm trying to look at the mini-map and I'm trying to find my friends using this mini-map mod. Maybe they're the purple dot on the map. There's no way that they could have gone this far in the world. I'm just gonna keep running. Okay guys, so I have just survived the night and I found the homestead that my friends have made. So let's go on a quick tour of their house here. So first of all, they have a cool Enderman there. Both doors open at the same time. That's pretty cool. They have some beds, a nice birch chandelier up there. They got quite the loot so far. Wall Almondy. Slaves. Interesting. Minerals so far. They already have silver and lead, which is pretty nice. They had a downstairs, so let's check out the downstairs. So the same birch chandelier. That's really cool. And they also have an upstairs, and this is pretty nice. So, yeah guys, I'm gonna go ahead and get things set up here and move in. And I'll check back in later, guys. Hey guys, I just wanted to turn my recording back on because I just walked through this door and I noticed that they also have a lot of farms out here that have been set up, and this is pretty cool. So I wanted to show you guys the rest of their base here. hey guys, I just found Johnny Tar, and Enderman, then I place flower. I'm gonna help him with this Enderman. These mushrooms. So this one is the gray shimmering mushroom. This one's kind of cool. It has a bit of a vibe to it. It's not my favorite, but it's pretty cool. This red mushroom looks stupid, and I do not like it. This mushroom is pretty pointy and cool, and has some cool particle effects that go around it, like the other mushrooms. This orange one is cool too, because it makes me feel things, and it looks like some kind of alien thing. The brown mushroom looks kind of dumb. The light blue mushroom looks really cool. I think this one is probably my favorite so far. Next up is the magenta mushroom. This one's probably a close second place, and then the blue mushroom is easily my third favorite. So the light blue mushroom is my favorite, the magenta mushroom is my second favorite, the blue mushroom is my third favorite, and then the orange mushroom is my fourth favorite. The black mushroom is probably my fifth favorite. This white mushroom is probably my sixth favorite. The brown mushroom is my seventh favorite. And the red mushroom is easily my eighth favorite. So I'm gonna ask my friend which mushroom your favorite, and see which one he likes the most. And if he chooses he likes the magenta mushroom. That's pretty cool. I like that one too, bro. Yeah, guys, so we're making some great progress here on the server, and let's see what other thing type of progress we can make next. Hey, guys, so I wanted to show you this really cool thing called the sleeping bag, and it lets you sleep anywhere. So you put it down, and then you can get in it, and then when you get up, you pick it back up, And it doesn't reset your spawn point. So, and then when you sleep, and then it gives you the sleeping bag net. It's pretty cool. And that's just a cool mechanic that I wanted to show you guys. Hey guys, so this is the next day in real life, and I wanted to give you guys a quick update on the Minecraft Vault Hunters survival multiplayer server. So once we join into the world, I'll show you guys some of the new things that we've done. Okay, so we're in the world now. First, I want to walk over here and show you guys the mushrooms. So these are the same mushrooms from before, but I found three new mushrooms. This one's pretty cool. I like it a lot. And then these two as well are really cool. I especially like the one in the middle a lot right here. I think it looks cool. So I've also been doing a little bit of work on the questing in Vault Hunters. So now I'm on the Vault Crystals quest, where we have to infuse the Vault Crystal right here with these items, and I'm really looking forward to doing that. And the current loot situation is in this chest we have a spare Vault Crystal and some other stuff, and then in this chest, this is where some of my mining has taken place. So we're doing pretty good on the server right now, and we're gonna go make the Vault Crystal now. Hey guys, it's me again. So I thought that it would be cool if we infuse this Vault Crystal together. Here we go. So we give it one leaf, and then a piece of iron, two sticks, and then a couple of rocks, and then when you press the button, then the Vault Crystal, the JO Crystal, becomes fully charged, and then we can use it. So let's open our quest book and accept our shulker box reward. This is basically a chest that we can mine and pick up, so that's gonna be pretty cool. Now we're gonna do the next quest. Maybe I'm gonna do it off camera, or maybe I'm not. We're gonna see. Hey guys, so I'm gonna give you guys a quick update on the situation. So we have a renovated mushroom hall, and I found some more mushrooms that I want to talk about. I really like this yellow one, and the green one is pretty nice too, and so is the cyan. And I put the red mushroom in the corner because it's stupid and I don't want to see it. I've done a little bit of questing, and I have the super vault enchanter, and I've made a crystal, the J.O. crystal, and I did some more mining. So I'm all kitted out, and I'm ready to do the vault, and then my friends are gonna yell at me because they have FOMO, but I'm going in the vault because I'm not a pussy like them. So this is gonna be a gameplay and commentary of my first vault. So it looks like we have to find, oh, I need blocks. Okay guys, let me just make a crafting bench real quick. And then let me make some of these slabs. So what we have to do in the vault is we have to find the monoliths. And we only have 25 minutes to do the vault, but I'll make sure to grab as many mushrooms as possible. And I'm just gonna try to do a little bit of marking so that I can find my way out. Okay, so we have our first enemies. These guys are kind of pushovers because I'm kind of geared up pretty strongly right now. I know this is only my first vault, but I kind of came into this prepared. So here's the first monolith, and then there's a couple of enemies. So I'm just going to watch my back as I dispose of these enemies real quick, and then pick up some loot. Here's the monolith, and if we just right-click on the monolith, then we activate it. The cool thing about the vaults is that you get to take all this stuff with you. So I'm gonna grab some of this hay, some of this stuff too right here. And let's go find the next monoliths and mine some of this stuff next to these scary enemies here. Actually, they're not that scary. So let's see. This is like a quarry thing. There's like a lot of cool stuff that you can mine in here. Some cool minerals and stuff. So let me just like quickly mine some of this up real quick and check my, okay, my inventory is doing pretty good. I'm not gonna mine all of this, but I'm just gonna get a decent chunk of it, and then we're gonna get going. Okay, so we came from over there, and then that's a hole down to the bottom, to the beginning. This is a monster spawner with creepers in it. So, oh, and then this is another mining station. So let's just see what we get this time in the mining station. I might do a little bit of jump cutting here and there, guys. So please bear with me as I tackle my first vault. So now we're going down to the floor that we came on, and let's go to the left first and kind of mark our way a little bit. I think next time I'm going to craft some carpets, because carpets are this is an interesting place with TNT. I like TNT. This surely is not going to blow up when I try to mine it. I hear scary enemies, but it's fine. We can just, can I? I'm hearing noise. Let me just use the TNT there to blow up the chests for me. Oh. I found the enemies, guys. Okay, guys. If I can get that creeper to explode, then that would be great. But let me just like look through this village first. My inventory is not doing great. And there's just TNT everywhere, guys, and it's kind of making me a little bit nervous. And I have a bunch of junk blocks on me that's taking up too much inventory space that I need to get rid of. I will keep the mushrooms, though, because I like the mushrooms. And these books are going to come in big handy, so I'm going to loot some of these books, and then I'm going to loot this chest here, and then I'm going to put... Can I take the chest with me? No. Okay. So let's go into the next house. Okay, so here we have some scary enemies, but because I have the tactical advantage, I can just kind of smack them like this, and then they just can't get me. Okay, I'm gonna blow up all of the loot that I just... Hey guys, that was a little bit of a blunder, it looks like. But you know what, guys? This was a great vault, and I'm really excited for the next vault. Hey guys, I'm back, and this time it's going to be a better vault, and we're not going to have a hiccup like we did last time. So this time we're only... That's a pretty cool little lantern here. I'm sure the vault won't mind if I just grab a couple of these, but this time we're not going to have any issues, and we're not going to blow up like we did. So let me just put some of those down. Okay guys, we have one monolith located. So let's loot these chests, activate the monolith, and then go rush to find the next monolith. Okay guys, we just found the last monolith. So, this is scary. What does this do? Can I just hit you? Okay. Okay guys, things aren't great right now. But everything is going fine. So let's just start looting once again, and then slowly make our way out. Okay guys, our chest is getting kind of full, which means that we have a bit of an upper limit to our how much more looting that we can do as we try to escape. Yeah, we're pretty full, so let's just book it now. Okay, so that is one of our things that we activated. So I think we just went in a loop, so maybe if we go this way now. So that's another... I've never seen this one before and it's not lit. So maybe multiple of those beacons spawn. Yeah, that's not right. Let me out. Okay, you know what? I gotta go. Where my exit? Here we go. I know where to go. I'm going because I know where to go. I got 2 minutes and 30 seconds left, but I know where to go. Hear me out, yo. Because I know where to go. I ain't being greedy because I know where to go. It gotta be a tragedy as I know where to go. I'm this little hunter as I go. Okay, which way next? Which way next? Well, it's not that way. Right? Did I do a wrong turn? No. Wait, yes. No? Oh, I gotta go east. So we go east. Why did I do like 4 here though? I'm so confused right now. I go east though. What? The exit's supposed to be east. Did I do a curve? Oh yeah, oh my god. I knew that one was gonna screw me up, man. Okay. Where to next? Okay. Alright. If only I could move just a wee bit faster, that'd be nice. Yeah, I think it's over. Seconds. 15, 14, 13, 12, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Oh! Oh my god! Wow. Oh my god. Show me the loot. Oh my god. I can't believe it. I may be stupid. But at least we made it. Transmog. Open. How do I open this? Do I break it? Ah! What do? Wow, so it's important to beat the vault, guys. Okay, let's open up a couple more loot crates, guys, and then we're gonna call it here for the for this episode. So we have a mystery box, we have a chest plate again, and then we have more really cool stuff that we need to unlock. thanks for watching this episode of Hajiet Does Vault Hunters with friends. I will see you in the next one. Please make sure to press the buttons. Thank you guys.